I will start out with an entity looking like this. Student name, address, the grade the student is attending, the classes and teacher info, marks scored in first marking period, second, third, and final marking period. These are its attributes. Student Sam, living in this address, in 12th grade, studying these subjects, have these scores. He's a cum laude student with these extracurricular activities, and Mr. Hannah as his contact person. Same can be repeated for Tom, who is a summa cum laude student. And Jerry's info is also there. Like that, there will be lots of rows. But for now, let us just work with this data. And pause this video for a moment to glance through all the rows of this entity, student info. You would notice a group of data being repeated in lots of places, especially the first three columns stand out prominently with repetitions. Let us simplify it. Let me break that object into three small entities. Let me move students' information into a separate entity called students. Students will have name, address, grade, status, contact person, contact phone of the student as its attributes. I've also given an ID for each student this time, and it will be unique, meaning that no two students will have the same ID. Now, if you look at the student info entity, I've removed the first three attributes. And replace them with just one attribute called std id, which is student id. Here, the values in this attribute will be related to the values in the student id attribute of student's entity. The first row, which earlier had the student Sam, his address, grade, has been replaced by an ID of 1. And if we check the student's entity, you will realize that I got that 1 from this one. 1 is the student ID of Sam. Now, if I need to read data, I can join these two entities. For example, I can select everything from student entity plus everything from student info entity with one condition, that is students dot student ID equals to student info dot student ID. I will get the same result as I would have read from the previous entity. So the important thing is the relationship between student info and students. Here, student info, student ID should have values that are always part of students, student ID. It cannot have a value which is not defined here in students, student ID. This means that student info entity is a child to students entity with regard to the attribute student ID. And students entity is a parent to student info with regard to the attribute student ID. This is called as a relationship. Also, for each row in students student ID, there can be many rows in student info student ID. This is called one to many relationship. There are one to one, one to many, many to many relationships possible in data modeling. Now, you may also notice that I have created one more entity. It's called subjects. It has sub underscore ID, which is subject ID, name, grade, teacher as its attributes. This is again part of reducing the repetitive data. I have removed the repetitive sets of data from the old subject and teacher attributes and replaced it with a new attribute called subject ID in the new student info entity. And this will be joined with the subject ID attribute of subjects entity. Here is also an example of a relationship where student info's subject ID is a child to subject's subject ID. Also, for each row of subject ID in subjects, there can be many rows in student info. So, this is also an example of one-to-many relationship. Now, let me see if I can avoid any more data repetition. Here, in this students entity, I see the value of status repeating. A school may have hundreds of students, and lots of students may have cum laude status, and lot may have summa cum laude status. So, if you expand this table, you would see a repetition of this status. So, why do I have to have these long words in each row? Let me replace them with numbers, thereby reducing the size of this entity. Let me create an entity called grad status and give an ID for each of these status and just put those numbers here. I can do the same for contact persons too. There could be a single contact person for multiple students. So I can keep evolving my design based on my need. And this process of avoiding repetition is called normalization. Like I said, data modeling is a vast subject, and please check out the documents for it if you are interested in it. If you do a normalization for the first time, like we did it here, the resultant entities will be in first normal form or 1NF. If you renormalize them, then you get entities in second normal form or 2NF. A normalization of 2NF entities will result into third normal form entities. And if you go through the data modeling documentation, avoiding the repetition alone is not a criteria. There are other criteria, but I'm just trying to simplify it. And OLTP database system should be in third normal form with regard to objects in it, meaning that there should be less repetitive sets of data in an entity. A DSS system doesn't need to be normalized like an OLTP system. Since a DSS system will be used for reporting, having repetitive sets of data will be much more useful. Thank you for watching this video.